Given f of x equals the quantity 3x squared minus 6x plus 5 raised to the third, we want to find f prime of x, so the derivative function, and f prime of 2. So the most important thing to recognize here is that f of x is a composite function, and therefore to find the derivative, we have to apply the chain rule. So before we find this derivative, let's review the chain rule. The chain rule is used to find the derivative of a composite function, where if we have y equals f of g of x, with u equal to the inner function g of x, then the chain rule can be expressed several ways. Here are three of the most common ways. To find the derivative of a composite function, we find the derivative of the outer function and then multiply by the derivative of the inner function. So looking at these notations, dy du, f prime of g of x, and f prime of u represent the derivative of the outer function, and du dx, g prime of x, and u prime all represent the derivative of the inner function. So if we apply the chain rule to the basic power rule, we get what's often called the extended power rule or general power rule. Where again, if we want to find the derivative of u to the n with respect to x, where u is the inner function, it's equal to n times u to the power of n minus 1 times u prime. Where again, this would be the derivative of the outer function, and this would be the derivative of the inner function. So going back to our example, the first step is to identify the inner function, which in this case would be the quadratic function 3x squared minus 6x plus 5. So we're going to let u equal 3x squared minus 6x plus 5. Let's also find u prime now. U prime, or du dx, would be 6x minus 6. Let's go ahead and write our function in terms of u. F of x would be equal to u to the third. So now we'll apply the extended power rule. F prime of x will be equal to 3 times u squared times u prime. Well, we already have u and u prime, so now we'll perform these substitutions. F prime of x equals 3 times the quantity 3x squared minus 6x plus 5 squared times u prime, which is 6x minus 6. Again, after a while, you'll probably go from the original function to this derivative function, but I think when first learning the chain rule, writing it out in terms of u can be very helpful. Where these factors represent the derivative of the outer function, and this represents the derivative of the inner function. But we can simplify this further. We can factor out a 6 from 6x minus 6. So we'd have f prime of x equals 3 times 6, leaving us with a factor of x minus 1. And we still have 3x squared minus 6x plus 5 squared. So we have f prime of x equals 18 times the quantity x minus 1 times the quantity 3x squared minus 6x plus 5 squared. So this is the first part of our problem, the derivative function. So now to find f prime of 2, we'll substitute 2 for x. F prime of 2 will give us the slope of the tangent line at x equals 2. It'll also tell us the instantaneous rate of change of the function at x equals 2. So we'll have 18 times 2 minus 1 times 3 times 2 squared minus 6 times 2 plus 5 squared. So we'll have 18 times 1 times, this would be 12 minus 12, that's 0, plus 5 squared. Well, that'd be 18 times 25, or 450. So f prime of 2 equals 450. Let's check the tangent line at x equals 2 to see if it looks like it has a slope of 450. Again, we found that f prime of 2 equals 450. Notice when x equals 2, the point on the function would be 2 comma 125. We'd find the y-coordinate by subbing 2 into the original function here. And notice the slope of the tangent line at that point is very steep, going upward from left to right. And because f prime of 2 equals 450, the slope of this line is 450. I hope you found this helpful.